And this is for the thumbnail. As you can see, we're gonna try this drone very, very hard. Hi everybody, and welcome back to my backyard. Today, as you can see, I'm wearing a Beta FPV shirt, and that's not random. In fact, I got their new product, the Pavo 30, and this is a 3-inch CineWhoop. And look at the box, it's super flat actually. Let's see what's inside. So, spare set of propellers and screws for the propellers. And look at these blades, these are 3-inch Gemfan D76 propellers, and they are mean. And also you get a box of parts. First of all, you get an hexagonal key, very nice, I always love when they include that. You get an angled micro USB adapter, so you can connect to the flight controller basically. And this thing again, this is the small 4K connector to naked GoPro, and I always wish they did the opposite, because more people are flying the GoPro basically. And lastly, you have a mount for a 19mm cam. And this is very nice, actually made in very high quality plastic. I like this trend Beta FPV is taking of providing very high quality stuff. And then lastly, we have the CineWhoop itself. And look at this beauty. Actually, I love the design. It looks very, very nice. It's all organic, curved, and wow. They did an amazing job on the design, actually. And also, it's hollow at the bottom, so it's not super, super heavy, which I like. Not bad. So, let's see the specs of this drone. This is a 3-inch, 118mm motor-to-motor. And this is the HD version, actually. So this has the Caddx Vista VTX and Nebula Nano camera. It's not the best, but it's the only one that's available right now, so it's fine to me. And they give you the adapter if you have a Nebula Pro or a Caddx Vista camera, the regular one. And this is also 173 grams like this, without battery or camera, and the analog version is 145 grams. We'll talk about that later. So, why all of this weight? This thing comes with super beefy 1506 motors, and paired with these props, I bet they're gonna have some serious power, because they are super big. And it comes with a F7 flight controller, 35 amps ESCs, and it packs a punch in my opinion. I can't wait to try and fly this. And talking about weight, the analog version with a 650 milliamps battery and a camera, 20 grams, it's gonna probably be sub 250 grams. This one, if you don't put a camera, maybe, if you put a camera, there is no way. Also, it comes with a super, super tiny lollipop antenna right here, and it's very nice. They also have a channel here to put the antennas for the receiver, which I have to put inside here. Also, this drone is made of very nice quality plastic. It feels very sturdy, and it's PA12, which is supposed to be crash resistant. I hope I'm not gonna test that. I hope I don't crash. And also, it has the regular old Beta FPV mount, and also it came like this with the front grommets open. But I like they put a screw here so it doesn't come off, and that's already an improvement. I already tested this mount and I was not very satisfied with it last time, so let's see if they improved on that. And also the open grommets give me the chance of showing you the quickest way to put them in. So the quickest way to put these grommets in is to take a small piece of rope and you just want to make it very, very thin like this. You slot it, it's gonna be hard to show on camera, but basically you slot it in the hole like this, you are seeing it, boom, and it's on the other side. Then what you want to do is you loop the piece of rope around the grommet. It's very easy, I did it off camera because it's easier for me, and then you just pull and boom, it's in. Look at that, super easy, and it's quick and painless. Otherwise, good luck. And also look at this strap, it's made of high quality, I like it, but the best feature is this thing is refractive, so if you go around at night and you look for your drone with your camera, you're gonna shine your flash and this thing is gonna glow, and I'm gonna show you inside. Now I'm in the basement because I wanna show you this, it's super cool. So you can see it's sunny outside, but it's very dark in here. I've hidden the drone in the frame. I'm gonna turn on the flashlight and you're gonna able to see it. Boom, can you see the drone? You can see a strap of light coming from down there. It's super cool actually. Look, the strip glows. So when it's night and you activate your camera flash, you're gonna be able to see it. And look at this, it's crazy. But one thing I don't super like about this strap is where it's at. It's at the dead middle of the frame. I wish it was a little bit back here, because yeah, you can carry a naked GoPro, but this thing I bet is gonna be able to carry even a full GoPro. So having the ability to balance the battery a little bit further back will be much better in my opinion. But let's see how it goes. Maybe I'm gonna try that as well. Right now I'm gonna put a receiver in this and fly without GoPro. Let's see how it flies, and then I'm gonna fly with a naked GoPro and maybe even put a big GoPro on it. So let's check this out. So don't look at my super messy bench. I wanted to show you how to open this drone because it's not straightforward. So you need to unscrew all four screws. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you need to unscrew all three down here. Yeah, those three. And then you need to unscrew another four screws down here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then once you've done all of those screws, it's pretty straightforward. It comes up like this, and it's very, very intelligent design, because you have the flight controller right here, and you have the Caddx Vista and camera setup on the bottom. And also you can unplug it and it becomes two separate entities. Very nice. I like the design. And also look at this. This is the wire that goes to the GoPro. These two wires are detached, I don't know why. I'm gonna use only these two ones and put a proper connector on the top. Perfect, I've done everything and the drone is ready to be reassembled. I installed my R9. If you have a FR Sky receiver, it will be the same basically. It's these three contacts right here. It's 5V, ground and RC. And also, if you are one of these units right here, you need to cut the S-Bus cable. I mean, it still worked even with the S-Bus cable in, but I don't trust it. Maybe this will send some signal and I don't want the drone to drop out of the sky. And also, as I told you, I installed the GoPro cable, so I don't have to use the adapter. And now, also, look at the antenna placement. It's amazing. Like, the antenna slots in there, as you can see, and it goes all the way inside here, and it's super, super, super tidy. Look at this, it's crazy. This drone, very good design. I like the design of this. Perfect, I just put it back together. I did a lap around the house to see if it works, and now I'm gonna fly without GoPro with a 650 milliamps battery. They suggest a 850, but I have this and it's lighter. It's gonna give it a best chance of flying good in my opinion. And also, as I was telling you, I'm not a big fan of this strap, because look at it, it's weird. The battery sits there, yeah, it kind of slides around and it can slide off. I mean, you have to pull, so I guess it's gonna be secure while you fly, but I wish it was a little bit more just about here, as I was telling you. Let's put it in agro and let's go. Activated. First of all, it has power. It makes decent amount of noise. It's not as noisy as the V3. Still, it's noisy. It doesn't fly bad. I was checking for Jello in the feed. There is a little bit, not too much. It's fine. The camera is hard mounted to the plastic, so the drone is not too bad with the vibrations. And it's got some power. Not bad. It was washout. It was not me. Yeah, that was not good. Let's try it again without the tree. Yeah, it's not me, I'm not giving throttle. So it has a little bit of washout. Probably we can counteract this knowing it. Hey, it's weird. Let's try it again. Yeah. Oh! What was that? Probably I hit a branch, I think. Or maybe it was a desync, I don't know. I'm telling you, I've not changed anything, and it's flying on a super light battery, which should improve the performance. It's not bad. You just need to watch out for that washout. Let's try it. Okay, now it's better. Because they sell it as a Cinewhoop that can do freestyle. So let's check on that. Yeah, it's not bad. It is not super gentle on the battery though. What? It was not me again, I was telling you. I hope when I put the GoPro for some magic reason it stops doing that, because it's weird. Yeah, it flies good though. It goes where you say it 90% of the time. Okay, I gotta land and quit. So okay. The timer resets every time. I guess we did 4 minutes, something like that. The battery is really, really hot. I don't like this because it's destroying my batteries. Motors, they are on like 38 degrees. I have the thermometer in my fingers. So, first impressions about this drone. Flies good 90% of the times. Like, you can do stuff, it's powerful. You can do power loops and rolls and freestyle. But when you are doing dives or going down like this, probably the duct design is not the best, maybe they didn't even test it in the wind tunnel, and it has washouts. So the drone, when it's coming down, applies throttle and it goes sideways or goes where you're not going, basically. And if there is a branch, you hit it. And you saw that, it was not me, I swear. And also, battery is still hot and I don't like drones destroying my battery. Of course, they suggest you 850 milliamps. But yeah, I mean, it's quite a big drone, but I've had 3-inch drone or even 4-inch drones and I'm running them with these batteries and they are totally fine. They fly for 10 minutes even. So this thing, 4 minutes, yeah, it's good. Big motors, yeah, it's not super efficient. And also, out of curiosity, I tried these propellers right here, 3-inch. And I was using them on my toothpick and they were amazing. So I was like, hey, let's give them a try. And no, it does wash out so hard, you cannot bring it to land. It's crazy. It doesn't want to land. It just goes higher. So you need to like spin it. And it was a terrible experience. So don't try other props because it's not gonna fly good. At least with the stock tune. Maybe it can be tuned, but I don't know. It's a duck thing. And now I'm gonna go design a mount for my naked GoPro and let's see how it flies with a naked GoPro on top. Maybe it will solve the washout, maybe? I don't know. Let's hope. Perfect, it's another day and I made the mount for the naked GoPro right here. You can download this base piece in the links down in the description below and you can use my kind of mounts. Also, I'm very happy to report that BDFPV kind of solved their wobbly issue and now it's not wobbly a lot. And this is because they included this screw on the back, so you tightened it a bit and the camera doesn't wobble that much. So I guess it will be much better than the BDFPV V3, the old one. Probably the new one, they included these screws. And that's a very easy fix actually, so if you have a wobbling V3, just put a screw in it and it will work amazing. And right now I'm gonna try with a couple of batteries. One is a 650 milliamps 4S battery and one is a 1300 milliamps 4S battery, because it fits on the back and it's probably gonna carry it. I'm curious to see. So let's try first with the small one, see if the GoPro records fine. I guess it will. And then we're gonna try with the bigger battery. Activated. With the GoPro on top, you can see some jello in the FPV feed. You can see it. It's terrible actually. I mean, it's not terrible, it's flyable, but it's not the best. It still flies good though. It should be more balanced. So why there is jello right now? I don't know. And if you remember yesterday, yeah, you just saw it. Yesterday I had some prop wash issue. So let's see. No, not prop wash. I had washouts. So let's see if today is the case or not. So yeah, the drone flies good, it has a bit more power than the 2.5 inches. Of course, it's a 3-inch. Bigger motors, much bigger motors. But it makes a ton of noise and it destroys your poor small batteries. That's why they suggest 850 for this. Yeah, with the GoPro on top, somewhat, I guess it's more balanced and it doesn't do washouts, not so far, at least. Yeah, it's good. Probably it's supposed to be carrying a camera on the front, yeah. It's a nice compromise between a toothpick and a Cinewhoop. Not bad. Yeah, I like it more than I thought. Probably I'm gonna use it, even if it's heavy. So a toothpick can do the same stuff on the open, and it's not as heavy, and you can fly for longer, and it doesn't drain the battery this much. So still, I don't know if having the ability to crash is worth the extra weight. Let's come back. Pretty warm and a little bit puffy. I don't like destroying my batteries. Now, without further ado, let's try with the 1300 milliamps. Big batteries have this issue, like, it's not a very good way of mounting a battery. No, I don't like it. I mean, it's not bad, but I feel like it's suffering. You wanna keep it? Oh my god. I mean, I'm kind of impressed it can do this kind of stuff. It screams like, whoa. Chill down, bro. Yeah, let's go, I don't wanna crash it. Want to fly slow? Maybe this will give you a nice battery time, but if you wanna do acro, don't use super heavy batteries, of course. Man, it screams like crazy. Yeah, it screams just like the bigger Cinewhoops. You know, there was a time where everybody was using those big Cinewhoops, and that's basically a ductless or very slim duct version of that. So it screams less than a ducted Cinewhoop, but I'm happy to report that motors are on the 50 degrees. It's not crazy hot. Yeah, they are very warm, but it's fine. It's fine. I expected the worst. So if you wanna fly with a big battery, you do it for Cinewhooping and not acro stuff, of course. Are you ready to see something super weird? And it looks fine until I move it. Yeah, this is not good at all. Like, this is very, very wrong. So BFP doesn't specify how you should mount the GoPro, and I assume you could mount it on the dampeners, but no, they are too weak for a full GoPro, so you should mount it directly on the drone. And I don't know, probably you need to design a specific mount for it. I'm not gonna bother doing that. I don't use a full GoPro on drones, it's just too heavy for me. But let's see if it lifts. It should lift it fine, and if I go slow it shouldn't move too much. So let's just see how it goes. So I watched the videos from the naked GoPro, they are perfect. So this solution with a naked GoPro is very good, it works very nice. Perfect, I'm ready to go like this. And as I was telling you, this strap should be moved a little bit more like here. But let's try and let's see how it goes. I expect it to be super, super noisy now. Activated. Whoa. Okay. There is a lot of jello on the FPV camera. Those motors are screaming. I mean, it still flies good enough. I have control, and that's crazy to me. I hope the motors are not burning. Whoa. I mean, if you wanna use it as a cine whoop, it's super heavy. I don't super recommend doing this, but it works, it can do it. I just feel like there are a lot better options than this. So yeah, the answer is you can carry a full GoPro, but why should you? Yeah, motors are very hot, but they are not alarmingly hot, you know, they are just like on the 60 degrees, so not super bad. And that's all for today's test with the Beta FPV Powoteri. I mean, I even carried a full GoPro, I tested this thoroughly. And also, look at the weight this thing can handle. And now I'm ready to give you an opinion about this drone. So, first of all, is it a good drone? Yeah. I found that it flies good, it's agile, you can freestyle with it somewhat. And if you're carrying some weight in the front, it doesn't wash out like it was when it wasn't carrying anything. I don't know why it was washing out, but that is my experience. Stock PIDs again. And the motors are powerful. It just sucks a lot of battery. It's not the most efficient drone I ever tried. On their website it says with a 850 1000 milliamps battery goes from 4 to 6 minutes. Today I tried with this, it does 3.5-4 minutes if you go slow. So yeah, it's not the most efficient. The quality is very premium, like Beta FPV is investing a lot in materials and looks. They design very nice looking, I mean, for me it's very nice looking, everything is encased perfectly, and when you look at it, it feels high quality. But they are doing some trade-offs I'm not super liking. I mean, I prefer a worse looking drone, but better in terms of function. Like, this battery strap, as I told you many times, is too centered. Should be back here, because the battery, I mean, you cannot put the battery down here. Or also, they could have put another place to place a battery strap down here. So having a lower mounted battery and the GoPro on top would be much better for flying with a full GoPro. The mounting system is somewhat better than the Beta FPV 95 V3 that was super bad. This one is fine, there is no jello, so Beta FPV has improved on that, even added this kind of screw in the back so the mount doesn't come off. I have one final consideration though about this drone. It's nice, but I don't understand its purpose, because yeah, it's made to carry a naked GoPro. Their website advises for carrying a Insta360, SMO 4K or a naked GoPro. But if you're going all the way into buying a SMO 4K or decasing a GoPro, it's because you want to be sub 250 grams. It's the reason those drones came to be and those cameras were stripped in the first time. This drone, there is no way it's gonna ever be sub 250 grams. So it kind of loses its purpose, you know what I'm saying? And in my opinion, there is a way to make a sub 250 grams 3-inch. This is not it. And if you wanna carry heavier stuff, again, this works, but it's not the best drone to do that as well. So it's kind of in that middle ground when it can do a bit of that, a bit of the other, but it just doesn't excel at any of them, in my opinion. And once again, I'm gonna take this Gepard C CineLog 25 as a reference, because in my opinion this is the best sub 250 grams drone for a naked GoPro. And this thing does like 90% of what this does. It's very powerful, you can do some freestyle, you can carry even a full GoPro, I've seen people do that, and it doesn't destroy your batteries. Like a 650 milliamps flies for 6 minutes, put something bigger, you're gonna fly for more. And if you're watching this video right now, it may be because you're considering buying a naked GoPro CineWhoop. This one is a good option, but I would recommend checking this one out because, in my opinion, it's better. So I will leave both links down in the description if you wanna check this out. Also, I have a review always links in description. And also let me know down in the comments, because I can make a video comparing the two of them. Let's get them to fight and let's see which one comes at the top. And as always, that's all for today. Consider subscribing and check the description as always. I'm happy Beta FPV is doing some progress with their drones, they are better. If you want an advice, try making a sub 250 3-inch drone. In my opinion, it will be amazing. Something like this, but lighter. It will be perfect. As always, stay safe and happy flying. Bye.